DR-DOS. What is DDoS attack, reflection, amplification? In this video, we will explain one of the worst types of denial of service attacks called distributed reflection denial of service. To do so, we will explain it in reverse order. First, DOS. I'm not talking about that old operating system, but a type of network attack in which an attacker overwhelms the system on the internet, for example, by sending a huge amount of traffic. As a consequence, people can no longer access the service under attack. Now, let's understand the character that makes the attack worse, the R. The character R in this context means reflection, which is basically a technique to abuse UDP services. UDP, by design, is a connectionless internet protocol in which the receiver does not validate the IP address of the source, thus the address of the client requesting a service. This lack of validation makes it possible that someone pretends to be you by sending packets using your address as source. This technique is called IP spoofing. Since it seems that requests come from you, a UDP server receiving such requests will send all responses back to you. This strategy is used by attackers and serves two purposes. First, to hide the identity of the attacker, and second, to amplify the attack. The first strategy is obvious, right? The target of the attack does not receive the traffic directly from the attacker, but from a UDP server in between, which acts as a reflector. The second strategy, amplification, is less obvious, but it is used to make an attack stronger than a direct attack. It exploits the fact that the size of server responses is generally much larger than the size of server requests. For example, when you issue a request for an IP address from a DNS server, your request needs only to include a single domain name. However, the response can include many IP addresses as well as additional information about the requested domain. In a recent study of us, we found that some DNS servers even amplify requests with a factor of 179. This means that, in theory, by using reflection and amplification, an attacker with a 100 megabit per second connection can generate an attack with 17.9 gigabits per second, using a single DNS server only. To make things worse, let's talk about the last character, the D. The D stands for distributed. In case of distributed attacks, we don't just use a single reflector, but hundreds or even thousands of them. Let's give an example. One of the biggest DR-DOS attacks noticed in 2014 misused 4,500 NTP servers to generate 400 gigabits per second of attack traffic. But this is just the top of the iceberg. There are not a few thousand, but there are millions of DNS, SNMP, NTP, and other UDP servers that can easily be misused to perform DR-DOS attacks. Concluding, if you are under a DR-DOS attack, the best you can do is to find someone that has far better internet connectivity than you and a good mitigation strategy to filter attack traffic. Don't forget to like and share this video and subscribe to our Flamingo channel. See you in the next video.